It was Russia's Olga Bicherova who left us breathless in 1981 when, as a mere 14-year-old, she became world champion. Well, today, 7 years on, Olga is back to delight us in the Vitalite Champions All International. And little doubt about the shining star in the men's section, China's Liu Yun, the world floor and vault champion and favourite for the gold medal here. Good afternoon from the National Exhibition Centre here in Birmingham. An impressive setup, isn't it? And with the Olympics only 4 months away now, this major event assumes even greater significance. This could be the last big chance for many of the international champions here to stake their claim before Seoul. If any nation can prevent the Russians dominating everything, it could well be Romania, who send their 14-year-old national junior champion, Cristina Bontas. From Bulgaria, there's Boriana Stoyanova, 21, and one of the outstanding women gymnasts in the world today. Not forgetting, of course, Fan Di from the People's Republic of China, a young lass who might just take Seoul by storm. So, a stiff challenge ahead for the British girls with Olympic places at stake. Lisa Grayson has her sights set on Seoul, as indeed does Britain's number two, Karen Hargate. Some tremendous talent out there today, Karen. Does it frighten you?
No, it's good. Good competition, good Romanian girl, and obviously the ex-world champion 1981, Olga Bicherova.
What about the Olympics, though, for you? I know this isn't a trial, but people are bound to be watching you and making their minds up.
This is a good warm-up for next weekend, the second trial. The first trial was a few weeks ago, which was a Bulgarian match. I did quite well in that.
How badly do you want to go to Seoul?
Desperate. I'd love to go.
And it doesn't matter that you're Britain's number two, does it? It's how you perform in the trials.
No, the trials count for the Olympics. That's what the trials are for. No, it doesn't matter what competition we did last year. The trials are this year now.
Well, let's hope you get what you want.
Thank you very much.
As for the men, well, reminder that we're going to see all the Olympic disciplines, six for the men and four for the women. Let's join our commentators Monica Phelps and John Taylor.
Boriana Stoyanova from Bulgaria already scored 9.5 on her first vault and was vault champion of the world right back in 1983. Another really good vault from her. Boriana Stoyanova. And 9.65. Such a good competitor.
And Britain's Lisa Grayson, 15-year-old, now her second vault. She scored 9.4 on her first. This is Sukahara straight. Nice vault. And just a touch better, 9.45. Fan Di from the People's Republic of China. This, her second vault, scored 9.75. A very good start for her on her first vault. Yurchenko with a full twist, not very high from the top, but a very solid landing. Arab Spring, somersault onto the horse, then 1.5 from the horse. Same score, 9.75. Score for her first vault was 9.55. This, her second vault. Yurchenko with a full twist in the cup position. 9.7 for the second vault. Karen Hargate already done her first vault and scored 9 points, then a tremendous start for her. Very determined young gymnast. A good vault. Yurchenko with a full twist in the puck position, just a little untidy as we'll see here, losing the legs slightly, but nevertheless a good vault and a good score, 9.7.
Well, this little lady, Cristina Bontas from Romania, just 4 feet 5.5 inches tall, the Romanian junior champion, and we know that the Romanians are a bit special at the moment, world team champions. Providing the world champion with Aurelia Dobre. And that's certainly a tremendous start from this little waif. Where does she get the power from? And what an opener, 9.8.
And Olga Bicherova from the Soviet Union, world champion in 81, European champion in 83, now 21 years old, and gracing us with another appearance. Not quite the gymnast that she was, but she can still turn out a Sukahara straight and score 9.5.
So, after the vault, the former world champion, Olga Bicherova, trailing in sixth place. Cristina Bontas of Romania leading with 9.8 from Fandi of China. Karen Hargate sharing third place, and Lisa Grayson is lying seventh. Back to the action, this is Lisa Grayson in some distress after a fall from the asymmetric bars in her warm-up. She landed on her chin and still looks a little bit dazed. Her coach, Colin, still there with advice. Let's just hope she's not too badly shaken.
And composed, ready for her asymmetric bar routine, Bulgaria's Boriana Stoyanova. She was fifth after vault, and this her second discipline. A little stuck in the full pirouette on the top bar, but a very difficult skill. A second pirouette and flight over the bottom bar. This is what the judges are looking for. Variety of skills on both bars. Flight over both bars. There, the giant circle, which comes from the men's high bar. And a shoot front dismount. An extremely clean routine there. And a good score, 9.45. And competition's a tough game. Here, having recovered from her fall in warm-up, Lisa Grayson, ready to perform her routine. And now we'll really see what she's made of. Past a handstand and the Jaeger. Just managing to keep the swing going, but she will be penalized for the slight pause. A very tight gymnast. And she's recovered very well. A smart routine, a double back dismount, and a good score, 9.4.
Yes, Lisa, proving she can take it on the chin and still come up smiling.
And Great Britain's Karen Hargate, just a little bit of spit on the hands to go with the chalk. The girl's very particular about how the hands are on the asymmetric bars. She's lying in equal third place, so she could do with a good routine to keep her placing. Just managing to catch a ginger. British girls really trying to master the release and catch moves. There, a clear circle and a heck to catch the high bar. But unfortunately, under-rotating the double back plank. What a shame after a very difficult routine. Not a bad score considering she had a fall. Romania's Cristina Bontas, very tiny little girl, having to use a board to leap over that bottom bar. Full twisting giant, as it should be done, straight into a catcher. Tremendous strength. And a beautiful rhythm, and this is something the judges are very impressed by. Another ginger. Men's release and catch moves, another full twisting giant, a really action-packed routine, full of difficulty. Excellent stuff.
Well, this is the first time I've seen this little girl, but already I'm prepared to bet that we're seeing a future champion in the making. She really is an amazing gymnast. 14 years old, too young to even be considered for the Romanian team for this year's Olympics. But she really is something. And another 9.8.
Cuba's Andrea Hulova from Czechoslovakia. Just managing the full pirouette. These gymnasts, tremendously experienced, and they learn to try and cover up their mistakes. Delchev on the high bar. The method in which they travel from the top to the bottom bar becoming more and more complicated as the years go on. A tall girl, but managing to perform clean giants and finishing with a good double back. Some very high scores today, another 9.5.
Andrew Morris in joint second place. To the rings, his third piece of apparatus. 9.5 there on the floor, 9.3 on the pommel horse. Can he keep it going? The inverted cross getting quite low into it. Every little waver on the rings, a fault. A second inverted cross. And the twisting double back to finish with. And 9.5.
And China's Fan Di. This little girl brought shrieks from the little girls in the audience as they watched her warm up. A tremendous asymmetric bar worker, scored 10 in the World Championships on this exercise, lying in second place. Brilliant technician, forward giants, and just look at the height of that Jaeger, and another flying swing over the bottom bar. Beautiful straight lines, immaculate technique. And the big dismount, and oh dear, didn't quite release at the right time, didn't tuck up tight enough, and drat, she says. Lost 0.5 and the lead.
What a pity, because it really was a very special exercise till then, but released too early. And twisting double back to front drop. 9.4, that shows you what a high score. Competition, Cristina Bontas of Romania setting the pace. She leads from Fan Di of the People's Republic of China, and in third place, Boriana Stoyanova. Britain's Lisa Grayson is sixth, and Karen Hargate tenth. So that's the position here at the NEC in Birmingham. We'll be back shortly.
Champions all event at the halfway stage then here at the NEC, and the ladies catching a lot of the attention with Cristina Bontas from Romania, the smallest girl here, way out ahead. What do you make of her, Hayley?
Cristina is a super gymnast. She's in fact in 14 years old, still a junior. She's very much like Silivas, Daniela Silivas, who won the European Championships. And I think we're going to see a lot more of her in the future, some spectacular stuff from her.
A lot of wiseacres, though, are saying equally good things about Fan Di from China, that she could really take Seoul by storm. Could you see that happening?
I can see that happening. She's instantly become a favourite of mine and many other people in the crowds today. She's an absolutely wonderful gymnast to watch. She's got a lot of style and grace, and she looks good, and I'm looking forward to seeing the rest of the competition.
She was brilliant on those bars until she fell off, wasn't she?
Well, I think she really showed how the asymmetric bar should be worked, and it was very unfortunate that she fell, but the content in that routine was incredible.
Tell me, what's the situation with the Brits then in the Olympics? They're going to be two men and two women, so we understand. Is that right?
Yeah, we now have two men, two women. The situation at the moment is they're still undergoing trials. The girls have been watched today, although this isn't actually a specific trial. They're out in Czechoslovakia in about 2 weeks' time, where they're all under scrutiny. Also, next week they have a big trial at Lillehammer National Sports Centre.
Who's your money on then, in the girls?
Well, I'd like to think that Lisa Grayson will make it, and also Lisa Elliott, but then Karen Hargate, I mean, it's hard going, and it's going to be a fight between the three of them, I think.
And who goes with Andrew Morris for the men?
Well, I really wouldn't like to say at this point. Again, it's a possibility of three lads. There's Ian Shelley in the running, who's here today, and also Terry Bartlett and Carl Bainan. So it's anybody's.
Right, well, let's move on to part three of this afternoon's event then, the men's vault and parallel bars and the women's beams. Here are John and Monica again.
And Bulgaria's Boriana Stoyanova. After the asymmetric bar routine, she was lying in third position, a 9.65 and a 9.45 under her belt. And at 21, she's got a wealth of international experience, and we could see another high-scoring routine here. She amazes me as to how cool she is on this piece of apparatus. At times she looks almost sloppy because she's so relaxed.
She really is as steady as a rock. Judges can't fail to be impressed with those landings out of the flick-flacks to layout back somersault, and then the flip again. Look at that. Just one little waver there.
On beam, it's only 4 inches wide, and confidence is the essence. You know exactly where you have to put your feet, and she did there. Double back dismount, extremely positive. And yes, another good score, 9.65.
Cristina Bontas to the beam, and let's go down to the floor for this one where Tony Francis and Hayley Price are looking at her in close-up.
She's the leader then, Hayley. You could almost put her in your pocket at 4 feet, 5 inches. She's good, isn't she?
Yeah, she's very good. In fact, too young to even compete in the Olympic Games.
14 at the wrong time.
Well, 14 in the wrong year, yeah. She's not 14 in the year of the Olympics. This is a very steady beam routine she's doing. She's got lots of skills in it.
She's going to be dangerous in 4 years' time then, isn't she?
I think she could be, you know, a star of the future.
Unless she grows, of course.
I don't think there's much chance of that looking at her.
What marks her out, then, as something special on the beam?
You can see by her attitude in training, she has a superb attitude. She gets in here, gets on with the job. And she's just solid as a rock on the beam. That was a free cartwheel into an aerial straight-back somersault. Quite an original move on the end of the beam. The Romanians, in fact, are very innovative on beam. They do very different stuff.
So what's coming now?
That's a changed leg split leap combination. Some very, very fast dance work as well. She doesn't stop at all.
As you say, really solid.
Not many wobbles at all.
She's extremely difficult on the beam, isn't it?
She's extremely confident for a 14-year-old as well, and that shows in her work, very precise. Two backflips into a double back somersault.
Another outstanding performance from Bontas. Look at this start. Yurchenko on and straight into flick-flack. Layout back somersault. No pause at all. And 9.8 again. Three in a row.
This is a little girl that intrigues everybody, Hayley. Fandi, who's the Chinese champion, which, considering their populations, not a bad effort.
Yeah, she's also a silver medalist on beam in the national championships. It should be a very good performance.
She can't actually catch up with Bontas yet,
even if she
gets 10.
Not at the moment. I think it's all going to be, you know, whatever happens on the beam. The Chinese are always very elegant on beam. They're a pleasure to watch, in fact.
Have you seen her perform on the beam before, this one?
I haven't, in fact. This is the first time I've actually seen the whole routine, anyhow. She has a sort of natural grace about her movements as well. We've just seen two backflips into a straight back somersault.
Does that make it as innovative as the Romanians?
In fact, this is quite an interesting beam routine. The Romanians quite often are a little bit more action-packed, but this, in fact, is almost on par with the Romanian girl. That's a forward roll, which we don't see very often, and is also quite an elegant movement. That's, unfortunate fall there, spoke too soon.
I was just going to say, she's as solid as a rock as well, like Cristina.
She was offline in the first movement. Very difficult combination, though, again, a straight-back somersault into her.
How many points could she lose for that?
That will, in fact, be 0.5 for the four. So that's putting her way behind Bontas now.
Well, she's got to perform well at the end.
Extremely well on the floor. I can't see her catching up. Double twisting, that's something called dismount.
Well, we await the floor anyway. Perhaps she can do it, because she is very good on that.
That's an unfortunate mistake, because she's so lovely to watch. But I'm looking forward to seeing the floor, because she's going to be very graceful on there as well.
If you're wondering what happened to former world champion Olga Bicherova, well, she's not really having a very good competition. She got a 9.35, quite a respectable score for not a very difficult routine on the asymmetric bars. But it was the beam that gave her the most trouble. And it's this fall on the dismount that gave her only 8.25 and left her out of touch with the leaders.
Well, no mistakes so far from Cristina Bontas. She's led from the start and goes into the final round with 29.4 points, a clear lead over Boriana Stoyanova. Fandi has slipped to fifth, just above Karen Hargate and Lisa Grayson. Join us for the exciting climax of the Vitalite Champions All after the break. Welcome back, and just the high bar for men and the floor for women to go in this Vitalite International. First to go on the high... Boriana Stoyanova to the floor in second place at the moment.
Years, and that's a long time to maintain the fitness and dedication required. Another example of her casual attitude in competition. That surely comes from experience. And that should assure her of the silver medal and one of the rare smiles. A good score, 9.65.
A 9.5 his score.
Czechoslovakia's Andrea Hulova, another of the many world-class gymnasts we've had here today, lying in fourth place, and this her last piece of apparatus. Tremendous amplitude in that handstand pirouette. Technically a very good routine, and a good score to match, 9.6. Olga Bicherova trailing in 10th place in this competition, but still enjoying her gymnastics very much.
Really here for the enjoyment. She's finishing this year, and of course she's a married lady now. Married to Valentin Mogelny, one of the great Russian male gymnasts, a member of their world championship winning team.
Thank you.
not as fit as she used to be, so she's struggling a little bit on that last tumble. The elegance is still there, but the fitness is certainly gone. 9.25 for Bicherova.
Fan D to the floor. Not really quite been her competition. Those mistakes on asymmetric bars and beam, dropping her to fifth place. But if she gets it right, she is certainly going to be a threat in Seoul.
Full in, back out, piked. Absolute cat-like agility. She's live and certainly not frail, a powerful gymnast, and we should look forward to her in Seoul.
Yes, Fan D, for me, definitely the most complete gymnast to come out of China. They've always been good on the asymmetric bars and the beam, but she's got the power to go with the Grayson style and finishes with a 9.8.
Karen Howgate's still smiling. Had an unfortunate hiccup on bars today, but otherwise a very good competition. Finished in sixth place in this competition last year and lying sixth at the moment. Positive pull in, back out, and just kept inside the floor. The British girls really are beginning to include the difficulties. Perhaps Karen lacking a little in the dance and elevation, but other than that, a brilliant routine. And a fitting score to finish, 9.55.
Well, we've seen two sensational new gymnasts in this competition, Fan D, and if anything, this little girl, Cristina Bontas, is even better. In the lead, she's had three 9.8s. Oh, and sky high there again on that opening tumble. Thank you.
choreographed routine. I would say Bontas isn't a natural dancer, but she's been very well taught to match the brilliant tumbling.
And it really was brilliant tumbling. That final double tuck back landed absolutely spot on. 4 feet, 5.5 inches tall. Non-stop action.
And what a prospect for the future little Cristina Bontas is. She had it all, agility, strength, and the composure and the ability to cope with the big day. And she's just strung 11 agility moves all together across that floor area. She is going to be a superstar. And there's the score, 9.8.
And nobody could match that. The Vitalite Champions All Cup going to 14-year-old Cristina Bontas from Romania. She led throughout the competition, kept her nerve, and finished a clear 0.8 ahead of Boriana Stoyanova in second place. And Fandy got back into the medals with that wonderful floor exercise. Karen Hargate and Lisa Grayson, 6th and 8th. But just look at the consistency of Bontas. 9.8s across the board. And she's not yet 15. Unbelievable. And confirmation of the result in the men's competition,